Holy shoot! Tropic just dropped Clouder 3.7 Sunnet, and I'm still picking up my jaw up off the floor after this announcement.
Ouch!
And look, I don't usually get hyped about AI releases because most are like 10% better at math or now with less hallucination. Those type of announcements, you know, that don't really change much, but this one is different. Now the 3.7 Sunnet isn't just another incremental update, it's a hybrid model with an entire new approach. Quick responses when you need them and deep reasoning when it matters. And you know me, I'm always thinking about enterprise use cases who are drowning in data, but starving for insights. So I think this one is promising. And why? Because most businesses' problems aren't just give me a quick answer that gets fixed with you are a customer support agent and boom, that's it. No. You need speed and depth. But what Anthropic buried in their announcement from my perspective and what I'm personally geeking about is Claude Code, which is a terminal-based AI coding assistant that runs locally throughout a simple NPM package. Your entire codebase analyzed and enhanced by Claude's reasoning power, running and executed at the console level. That's what we're testing today. Let's do this. So here's my app. It's an AppSmith application for a customer 360 report I'm building. In this particular case, what I want to have is maybe Claude to understand the structure and generate new widgets out of nowhere. That will be cool. Now, the beauty of an AppSmith application is that you can put it in source code. And here I have it connected to my Git repository. I'm in the stage branch and this public repository should be linked in the description so you can see everything that is going on over there. So once I pulled in my local environment, I already installed the Claude CLI tool, and it's just as simple as just tell Claude to invoke it. And I'm gonna tell it, this is an AppSmith application. It has all the configuration for widgets, pages, data sources, and beyond for a given app. Please analyze it and understand all the structure. It's important to tell it please and thank you, okay? Structure, there you go. So what I'm expecting here to happen is that Claude is going to recognize the structure of the AppSmith application, which has an application JSON metadata file, which contains all the structure. It has pages, data sources, and widgets, everything is there. So I'm expecting it to understand the whole structure, and then I'm going to ask it for generate new widgets, new pages, maybe even to create a new data source. We'll see about that. So it's right now running the task, which is analyzing the structure of the application, is going through all of the files, which is great, and let's see what it understands about it. All right, awesome. It took 35 seconds, 22K tokens, and it's telling me that the application repository has the structure for the root config file, data sources, the pages, the widget, and the app appears to be a customer 360 dashboard that displays user data in a table with search and date filtering capabilities. Now, out of the box, that's great because Claude is not actually looking at the UI of our application. It's just looking at the code base of a low-code platform. Now, that already is pretty cool. So I'm going to tell it I need a new widget. I'm typing super bad today. I need a new widget next to the date filter to use it for future features. Create an input widget over there. And let's see what it does. It's conjuring, it's understanding the task, and it's probably determining where it should enter the code for that particular widget to be created. Let's see what it does. Okay, so it just generated this input to JSON. It's a brand new file within the page one widgets folder, which is great. It also read the date picker one JSON file, probably to maybe understand what the structure is and how to locate it next to it. I'm gonna say yes, just took a glance of it. I don't think if it's perfect, we'll see how it goes. And it created a new input widget next to the date picker, same styling and vertical position, label filter by keyword, filter icon, and position directly to the right of the date picker. Now, this is interesting because the AppSmith Canvas UI is, you could drop in a widget anywhere. that could be easy to achieve, but actually put it where I want it. That's also what I'm looking for in terms of Cloud Day, if it's actually able to understand how the Canvas system works within the code base. Now, I don't know if this is going to work, to be honest. I'm just going to commit the stuff, you know, commit the code. And probably Cloud Day is going to generate a Git commit right now for me. That's also pretty cool, actually. You can integrate with Git over there, straight within Cloud Day without having to actually go out and run the Git command. Yes, do that, please, for me. All right, changes committed successfully. Let me go back here to my Git client, push to origin stage, and get it up there in the cloud. Let's go back to the app. And once here, what we should be able to do is just refresh the page. And what's going to happen is AppSmit is going to go back to the repository branch and see if there's any change. So it seems that we have two changes. Probably one is the merge and the other one is the actual commit. So let's pull those changes. And a couple of seconds later, AppSmit is going to refresh itself with the new changes. All right, let's give it a shot. And there you go. I see the filter by keyword input next to the filter by date. So it actually did it for me. If I deploy this app, I should be able to see the change, and here it is. Let me tell you, this is pretty powerful. Like, you know, it's just an input, you might think, but the fact that it understood everything and put it at the place that I wanted and understood the whole structure, it means that it can actually generate stuff for me at the CLI level. That's pretty powerful, honestly. Now let's see if we can create something beyond just an input. Let me go back here and say, I'm typing in all caps. I don't want to yell at it. I need to create a new page.
Complete the page to display data from the same data source, but the query should pull only the users whose gender is female. Because I see there is this gender column in the table, just make something quick. So create the queries, which is a necessary code to create this brand new page.
Let's see if it goes beyond just adding a new widget. That could be pretty powerful, to be honest. All right, just finished creating something. Pages, female users, femaleusers.json. Let's tell it JS, because it should not only create just the page content, but it should actually create a query. There it is. It's going to create female query, query.txt. The query is an SQL query because it's a Postgres database. Let's tell it JS. It's probably now generating other stuff, the metadata, that's great. All right, probably now the widgets, now that it has the query, the data source query configuration, and now it's probably generate the actual page folder with the widgets and the pages. Let's see if it actually does it. That would be, again, pretty shocking, to be honest. All right, it created more stuff here. It's generating a bunch of things. Let's just say yes. I'm gonna trust you, Cloud. Just go ahead and do it. Let's see if it works. Yep, let's edit the application JSON because it's adding the new page to the whole configuration of the app. That's also true. And it's already committing, I think. yeah, let's do that. I've created a new female users pages with what I needed. A new page is ready for you to commit. All right, commit the whole thing and see if it actually works. All right, changes committed successfully. Let me go back here to my GitHub and I see the changes. I see everything in there. Let's push it to the repository. Awesome. Push to stage. Now let's go back to our AppSmith application with the new widget over there. I'm still surprised about this. It's awesome. All right, we got two new commits, the merge and the actual commit. Let's pull it down and let's refresh the app once again. So in theory, if everything worked, we should go here where we have the pages. And now, I see the female users page. Let's click over there and boom, it has the table. Oh, this is pretty neat. It's showing the female users. We have the query here, female query. Awesome. If we run it, we see the response from the query and we have the UI widget. If we deploy this, here's the app, here's the page with the new widget and the new page completely generated out of nowhere from Cloud Day. Now, in my opinion, this integration isn't just impressive. It opens a world of possibilities. While the example was simple, think about scenarios like this. An AppSmith application that involves and grows based upon user feedback. new features automatically generated and PRs being done when your sales team logs customer requests, or automated UI improvements when analytics shows users struggling with a specific workflow, or even nightly builds where Cloud Day analyzes your data structure and changes and updates your app accordingly. Since AppSmith is open source and your apps lives in Git, you could eventually hook Cloud Day into your CI/CD pipeline to review and enhance your commits, or even create autonomous improvement loops where user metrics trigger app evolution. Wow, I mean, this is just about faster development. It's about systems that improve themselves. So what do you say? Try AppSmith AI and our agents today and be part of the future where apps evolve with your businesses, integrating with all of your data sources, embedded in your existing systems, private, secured, and integrated with all of these different models that are being published. What do you say? Take a look now.